Sustainability is essential for us because if we're not sustainable, we don't have a business. That's basically the bottom line. We operate in a marine environment, and it is important for us that it continues to be healthy. So we have to make sure that we have the infrastructure that supports an operation that is sustainable.
In 2005, Carnival Corporation set sail on its sustainability journey. Carnival is the world's largest leisure travel company, and it's established 10 sustainability goals across three themes: the environment, safety, and labor and social practices.
We have six goals focused on the environment, so the majority are focused on the environment because that's where our business is focused, on the seas and the pristine environments. The main goal is our carbon goal, which focuses on reducing emissions by 25% by 2020 compared to our 2005 baseline. And we've actually almost already achieved that. We have an exhaust gas cleaning goal, which is focused on air quality. Then we have a water and waste goal, a 5% reduction in waste rate, and a 5% improvement in water use efficiency as well.
Carnival has been using exhaust gas cleaning technology since 2013. Today, more than 70% of the fleet has these scrubbers installed.
That means a fleet-wide effort to reduce the emissions on our ships, and particularly the sulfur emissions. Both existing ships and new ships are receiving this technology. It works by using seawater to scrub the exhaust of the diesel engines, and that removes the sulfur and many of the other particulate matter and noxious gases as well. It meets all the new rules and regulations that are in place now and coming up in the next years, but also dramatically lowers our emission signature.
Carnival is also starting to use cleaner fuels. It was the first cruise company in the world to use LNG to power its ships at the dock, and its first fully LNG-powered ship is due in 2018.
The whole industry, not just the cruise segment, but the whole industry is looking to use cleaner fuels for the use in 2020. We are the first cruise company to utilize LNG. It's the cleanest fossil fuel available. It has about a 25 to 28% reduction in direct carbon emissions, so you immediately get a benefit on greenhouse gas emissions. However, probably the most impactful area is on its zero SOx emissions. It doesn't have very high particulate rates. You're getting to about an 80% reduction in particulates and around about the same in nitrogen oxide reductions. Really, it has a huge, huge benefit on its environmental impact.
Next generation ships that we're building will run on liquefied natural gas, whether at sea or at the dock, and they'll be the first of that type of ships in the world. Our first XL, or next generation new build, will be delivered in the latter part of 2018, and it will trade in Northern Europe, followed by a second ship in 2019 in the Western Med, and then so on to our last LNG ship of this existing order, which will be delivered in 2022. So 10 ships that will be engaged in some sort of LNG fueling and power.
Using LNG as fuel does require more space. It takes about 1.8 times approximately the space that you would otherwise take with a conventional liquid fuel. So there are downsides to it, but that being said, we believe that by careful design and by ensuring that we've optimized everything, we can make sure that that is not a negative.
Optimizing operations is key. If you can reduce the amount of fuel you're using, you're naturally going to reduce your emissions too.
You start, of course, with the speed of a ship. You have overproportional consumption as faster you go. So you reduce the speed, but you are doing that cleverly by early departure from the port or late arrival in the port to maximize your experience for the guests. Second biggest consumer are cooling of the air. So we have replaced the chillers, which are responsible for the cooling of the ships, with more efficient chillers. And that has drastic reduction in consumption. We have done a lot of efficiency upgrades in relation to our hydrodynamic to reduce the friction between the hull and the water, or make the propeller and the propulsion more efficient, and with that again reducing the consumption. So there is multiple facets of initiatives going on the electrical, propulsion, mechanical side, which are quite deep.
That's just the first waypoint on Carnival's sustainability journey. Learn more about their safety, labor, and social practices in our next video. If you like what we're doing here, please subscribe and tell us something cool in the comments. But for even more innovations disrupting the way that we live and work, chart a course for theneweconomy.com.